This is Confessions of a Refashionista.
Hi, hi! I'm here at the Salvation Army Thrift Store with Heike, the winner of the Shop with Sherry contest, and we are getting our shop on! Ooh. Stay tuned and see what we buy! Groovy gear Heike scored with her $20 gift certificate from the Salvation Army. What'd you get?
I got three things. So one I'm wearing, a t-shirt that I could easily just throw away and I can wear. Then I got this lovely skirt. Actually, it's a dress, but I would like to wear it as a skirt.
Mm-hmm. Pretty cool maxi skirt.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so maybe we need to sew it there, but really nice.
And or it's then, just, you know, the cool deconstructed look.
Actually, yeah. Yeah. That's what I thought, sure. And then I was looking for And then I was looking for a blazer and I found one in a really nice color. But well, the shoulder pad is
yeah, the shoulder stuff. Pads are a little bit too much. Mm-hmm. So we're gonna have to take them out, I think. So that'll be a upcoming tutorial. Stay tuned for that. But the thing that we were a little bit shocked about, to be honest, is for $20, that's it. A shirt, a blazer, and a skirt that has most certainly seen, you know, better days. So we got to chatting and thinking, you know, it's no wonder that people resort to fast fashion instead of shopping pre-loved or sustainable eco-fashion. Because first of all, anything that is kind of marketed as sustainable, it's very, very expensive usually. And then going to the thrift store, if you're kind of spending the same amount of money that you would spend in a fast fashion store, why would you buy secondhand when you can buy brand new? Unless, of course, you're an eco-fashion warrior like myself. But I really want to know, you know, what are your thoughts? Let me know in a comment below. Do you agree that thrift stores kind of really need to maybe lower their prices?
Yeah.
You know? Yeah. Because things are all donated. And
yes, exactly.
Yeah. And yeah, maybe thrift stores also need to be a lot more transparent with their pricing.
That's a lot of money for thrift store, right?
Yes,
like
yes.
The dress was $9 still.
Exactly, right, and it's not in great condition. So we're just curious as to, you know, how do they get to their prices? Is there somebody in a back room, they just have a chart that says something that is this much?
All dresses $9, yeah.
Exactly, looks but we nice. Know that's not true because there was dresses there for $6.99, for $14.99, for $19.99, you know? So yeah. it's kind of a bit of a conundrum. So thrift stores, be transparent. Thank you.
Your nail color is matching those stuff. Did you know that?
I did not know that.
Yeah, you need to play more here, like.
So, Heike and I are actually from Germany. Well, I'm not from Germany, but I lived there for 8 years, so I'm kind of from Germany.
Yes,
you are.
I am.
You are.
I am from Germany.
Deutsch.
Yeah.
So. Yes. And so again, while we were on our little funky little thrifting trip, we were talking about the differences between thrift stores here and in Germany. And what is the major difference, Heike, between the thrift stores?
So they're way, in Germany, I think they're way cheaper. So the stuff is either given and people want to sell their own stuff and the thrift store just gives it like further and people get their own money for that.
Yeah.
Especially with the kids secondhand stuff.
Lots of kids like stuff. Yeah.
Secondhand shops, right? And like I could have got a t-shirt for €1 or €2, that would be like $1.
Yeah.
So that's a big, big difference.
Yeah. And the thrift stores that I went to in Berlin, they're actually called a Sozialladen. And they are predominantly seen as, you know, for poor people. Kind of how thrift stores are here, but I mean, of course, here they're a lot more mainstream, hence the higher prices, I'm assuming. But the thrift store I went to, every second Monday, I believe it was, everything was 1 euro. Every single thing in there was 1 euro, or, you know, like plates for four for a euro type of thing. Mm-hmm. But even then, even on a non-sale day, the prices were super cheap. I don't think I ever spent more than 2 euros mm-hmm. on a jacket or, you know, on a regular price day. And so again, thrift stores in North America, why? Why was this blazer, what was it, $6? Mm-hmm. Why was this $6? Why was this $9? You know, when, you know, inquiring minds want to know.
Even that t-shirt was $4 that I found out that it's 100% acrylic.
Exactly. Exactly. Yes. And again, these are not high-end brands. None of these. These are actually items pretty much from fashion stores originally. So again, the original prices would have been incredibly low because they're unethically produced, of course. But yeah, just that's our big question is why? Why? So if anyone has an answer, come on, let us know in a comment below. And like I said, we're going to be taking the shoulder pads out of this. As you can see, it kind of all needs to be taken apart to get the shoulder pads out. It's not wonderfully convenient where we can just snip them and they're gone. But let's head upstairs and see what we can find in Heike's wardrobe to transform for her wardrobe refashionista makeover. Whoa! We found a load of stuff in Heike's closet to get refashioning, but first we gotta sift through it all and decide just what groovy combinations we're gonna put together. So after going through that mountain of clothes on Heike's bed, we chose this rather beautiful sweater that, why haven't you been wearing this, Nadia?
So this is a kind of a length, I don't know, it's too long as a pullover, but it's too short as a tunic, and I never feel well in that.
Right. So we're going to just do something super simple with this, so because the shape is really nice, and maybe it just kind of needs to be cut off to the correct length so she can wear it. And this absolutely adorable dress that, as you can see, still has the tags on. And people, she brought this from Germany with the tags on it.
Terrible. I never wore it. I have this now for 2 years.
2 years. Or 2 years. More. So, yeah. We just wondered, what was the designer thinking putting these kind of elastic bands on this super adorable, pretty dress. And then, yeah, you have elastic armbands. Not super
attractive. They don't look pretty.
No, they don't.
No, I
didn't so,
like it at all.
Again, another relatively simple refashion, but I think it's going to have a super dramatic result. And I'm thinking some vintage lace from my stash just might be, added to the sleeves somehow. So stick around for the next video. And we're gonna get making.